So I will now show you a test case where actually I have actually created it, and we will use this new executable and see how it solves the heat conduction in a rod. Okay. So for that, I will just go to my Laplacian form. Okay. And so I have a test case, my Laplacian form, and I will share this code with you so that you can try it with later at home. Okay. So it is already run. So what I'll do is I will do form clean tutorial. Okay. Which will clear this case. So now let us see what are the comments. We have zero, constant, and system. Okay. So you are already aware of this structure. So let us now quickly go to the zero folder and see that we have only one initialization, which is temperature T. We do not have pressure or velocity because we are solving only the Laplacian equation. So this case I have modified from the basic cavity case. Okay. You can copy the cavity case from your tutorial and then modify it. And I will also share this case with you guys so that you can play around with it. But now ask me if you have any doubts. So let us see in the T what I have there. So you can see that my object is T. So you can just copy the pressure file and modify these things. And the important thing is dimension. So you can see this, my kg, meter, and second, those are all zero. And after that comes the temperature, the dimension set that I have shown, right? So one means that it is the dimension of temperature. It tells OpenFOAM that, see, this is a temperature variable. Internal field we do not need because there is no time derivative. So it's just it's a special equation. We do not need any internal field. That will be a dummy line. So now we are going to solve this one-dimensional heat conduction problem over a rod. Okay. So I have a rod starting from x equal to 0 to x equal to a finite value, let's say 10. And then I have two boundary conditions to solve this boundary value problem, which is a one-dimensional Laplace equation. So here at x equal to 0, I have defined the patch as x mean, and in the outlet, I have defined it as x max. Everything else is empty because this is one-dimensional. So we are just solving it one-dimensionally.
So sir, after doing this, when we create our test case, yes. Do we have to do anything in the FP schemes because we are modifying this case file?
Yes, I mean, those I'm coming one by one. So now I am in the zero folder. So in the zero folder, you see that we need only temperature. That's why I have only a T file. I'm coming to the FP scheme, okay? One by one. So here, the important thing is boundary condition. So in the X mean and X max, the inlet and outlet patch, we see that we have given the fixed value of, let's say, 300 at the starting and at the end as 100. So 300 Kelvin and 100 Kelvin as temperature. And it is dimensional. Please keep it in mind. And the other parts are empty because we are not solving in Y and Z direction. If you are interested to make it two-dimensional, then you have to add Y mean and Y max and then give boundary condition for that. Okay. So now let us see what are the other cases. So I have now constant folder. Okay. So if I open the constant folder, I have transport properties. Okay. But this is a dummy file. You should not delete it. It will show error, but we do not need it because we are not reading any extra constant for my equation. It's just Laplacian of T equal to zero. There is no constant. Okay. But I do not have the polymesh folder. So we have to do the block mesh dict. Okay. So just go to the system folder. In the system folder, I have block mesh dict, control dict, FV schemes, and FV solution. Okay. Right. So in the block mesh dict, I will open and see what is my geometry. So I have modified the cavity case and made my geometry of a rod, which is very simple. It's a rectangle, right? I will show you in ParaView how it is. But my vertices is 0 to 1. So x equal to 0 to x equal to 1. Y is minus 1 to plus 1, minus 0.1 to plus 0.1. And z is minus 0.1 to plus 0.1. Clear? So that means that it is a rod. It's a three-dimensional rod. But we are applying empty boundary condition in the y and z direction because it's a one dimensional. And important thing is we are grading or we are discretizing the domain only in the x direction. Okay, is it clear? We are not discretizing in y and z direction because we are solving a one dimensional problem. So let us first do a block mesh dict. So block mesh and run the geometry. Okay, my geometry is run. Let us now see what are these in ParaView. So for doing ParaView from Windows Subsystem Linux, you need to have a X server, which I have. Okay, can you see my ParaView screen?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so I will just do show patch name here and I will apply it. Should come. Yeah. So can you see my geometry? Yes, no, maybe.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this is the geometry that I've created with two paths, mainly inlet and outlet. Okay. And if I see the grading, actually, so I can see that I have divided it, okay, into 100 parts along the X axis, but in the Y and Z axis is 1, 1, right? So it's only discretized along the X axis. And I have two patches. One is X mean and the X max, where I have applied the boundary condition, which is the red and green. Okay. So this is the geometry. What I will do is I will see to CD system and I will open the control dict, which is the main control, you know. So here you can see that the application name you have to given. So it was my previously compiled solver. Now we will change to new Laplacian form. The application would be, we are not using the existing Laplacian form. We are using our newly compiled new Laplacian form. And start time, end time, all this you should know by now. And I'm not changing anything. Okay. So I'm just changing the application name to be new Laplacian form. Sorry. And you should understand that this is actually our solver, which we actually compiled. Okay. Now I will go to, okay, in the system itself, I will go to FB schemes. Okay. Here, what I have changed is I have changed the DGT scheme of steady state. Okay. Because this is Laplacian equation in steady state. So I have changed that. Other than that, I have not changed anything. The scheme only I have changed from Euler to a steady state, which is used in simple form. Okay. It's a steady state equation. Now, if I see FV solution, okay, you can see that I have only one solver, which is T. Okay. So solver, I'm using the pre-conjugate gradient method with a diagonally incomplete Cholesky preconditioner with the tolerance and relative tolerance. And my solver here is simple, which Dr. Janani already explained you the methodology and the background of it. So now it's clear that you have a T equation, which solver for the T equation, and you have the methodology to be defined as simple, which you have already learned. And we are not using any residual control. So I have commented it. Okay. And the non-orthogonal characters are the measures related to the mesh. So I'm keeping it as zero. I'm not changing it. So only thing I've changed is in the control dict, the application name you have to change to your new solver that you have created. Okay. So let us go back. And now I've created block mesh dict already. So let us now run my solver. So the new Laplacian form. So if you the executable is there, after new, you just press tab, the solver will come. Okay. New Laplacian form. And just run it and see if we are getting any error, because block mesh dict we have already done. Okay, voila, we are all set. We are getting some solution for the temperature. Okay, so let's see how it looks. Okay, it is running for, I think I have not mentioned the end time properly. So it's running. Okay, it's run. So you can see that there is no problem using our newly compiled solver for Laplacian form. And now let us see the results. Okay. So for that, I am doing parafoam. Okay. Now I will be seeing temperature. Okay. And with surface, and let us see whether the, yeah. So you see the initial boundary conditions, right? One is at X mean, the red, and the other is at the X max. Okay. So now you see that the temperature is starting. So when we'll start from zero. So at zero, there was no temperature in between the rod. It was only in the initial boundary condition. Then it has solved the Laplacian equation along the X direction, which is in this mesh, along this mesh. And when we run it, it solves the heat conduction equation due to the temperature difference between these two ends. Okay. So that's very nice. So we have written a solver, compiled it, and we have solved the test case using it. So I will stop here. And
thank you, Professor Chandan, for that really interesting session. I'm sure many of them are still chewing on this, but like you said, if you have any questions, please go ahead and post it. Hi, Sheetal. Yes, we will plan to do this. Like I have mentioned in the past also, we will discuss this once with Professor Janni and Professor Kannan and share with you as many sessions as we can over the past 3 days.
Okay. So, I just wanted to have some confirmation. If you have, any of you have been able to, you know, use your newly compiled solver, and where are you facing problems? I can spend some 5 minutes to, you know, clarify those. And if you have overall any doubt throughout this, because I know that over Zoom, where I cannot see you and understand you, it's a difficult thing to understand. But please let me know quickly if you need some quick clarifications or if you are getting some errors. 1 minute. Yes, so this is just to share my contact details. If in any case you have some doubts or clarification you need, please, you can feel free to, you know, mail me and ask regarding this lecture. Okay. So please.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Thank you, sir.
So I am also typing here my mail ID. So regarding this lecture, if you have any clarification needed, you need any clarification, you can contact me with this mail ID.